Welcome, Prestonians. Our topic for today is confirmation. And of course, it's a very vital topic for our IGCSE. But most of the materials you'll be coming across for this topic are online. It's a straightforward topic and exceptionally very simple. Though there are slight variations with the way certain Christian traditions hold onto this sacrament or practice in the church. Let's look at the lesson objectives. Let's look at the definition for confirmation. Now, the Catholic Church sees confirmation as the enablement of an individual to receive wholeheartedly the full grace and benefits of the manifestation of the Holy Spirit. In Catholic tradition, it is believed that after a person has been confirmed, that person is now entitled to receive the fullness of the grace of God and the fullness of the manifestation of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. The Catholic Church strongly holds on to the fact that confirmation comes with other benefits. One, that it enables the individual to become more mature in Christ. It gives the individual the grace to be able to shoulder the responsibilities of not only himself in the Lord, but even for the church. The Catholic Church also believes that confirmation strengthens the relationship the individual has with the Lord and also with the church. But when we look at the definition of confirmation with reference to the Protestant church movement, it is not completely different from that of the Catholic Church. The Protestant church sees confirmation as a practice that follows the biblical, of course, the church rite of passage known as baptism. Baptism definitely must come first, and then confirmation definitely follows after. The Protestant church sees confirmation as a sealing, that means they see confirmation as making perfect the bond and membership that an individual has in the body of Christ and also in the church. Now, I've been stating some of the rules of confirmation. It is seen as a rite that is encouraged to be practiced in the church. But certain church traditions give certain conditions. Some church traditions give certain conditions for the practice of confirmation. In some church traditions, the confirmation is carried out upon the individual when the individual is seen to be of age. And this is probably, most probably, between the ages of 8 and 14. This year group known as the age of reason. For some Protestant churches, the age could even be beyond that, especially for adults who have just accepted Christ into their lives. But churches who teach infant baptism do not practice confirmation, and this is very peculiar, especially with the Baptist church. I want you to make good use of the links I've given you, because most of the information we have on confirmation is online. So go through the links I've given you on Google Class, read through those links, watch the video, and ensure you have a good understanding of what has been passed across to you. I'm convinced that you do well in the course of your class starts. Thank you.